Did you know that you could use graphs in Notion? Were you aware that you could use graphs in Notion? Do you wanna, let's do the thing.
Is this real? Are these Notion graphs? Are these based off of these databases? Yeah, they are. Let's dive into how to make this happen. So if we go first and foremost to notioncharts.io, what we have here is a website that can let you make all the graphs that you see. If we go into one of these, you'll see that there are different types of charts you can have. You can have pie charts, donuts, bars, histograms, line graphs, area, all these sort of things, right? And obviously there are different use cases for different things within these graphs to get the visualizations that you want. So if we go right back to Notion, I can actually show you how I made this specifics graph. So essentially what you're going to want to do is make a table and then make sure that it has a breakdown of various things. So for example, what I have here is a monthly overhead breakdown, which just literally had the different like expenses that the costs of this Rise Productive brand have going on. So if we have like Google Business Plan, Super, which is like the website hosting that's connected to Notion, Envato Elements, it's an average of a 12-year cost, TubeBuddy, and Google Domains. Then we take that sum and we can see it's like $41. And then we look at like how much money we have expected coming in. This is a mock-up, and $230 is maybe an example of what somebody could be making. And then at the top, I just casually wrote what would I think the expected income would be. But if we want to see a breakdown of said visualization of like, where is this money specifically coming from? Because I'm not really sure, you know, what percentage makes up what. I think I want a better visualization. So if I refresh this, this chart is actually something that I got rid of. So I'm gonna basically delete these two and go back to the charts website and make these for you guys. So if we delete this and delete this, I wanna go through and give you an example of how to make these charts. At the start of this whole process, what you're going to want to do is basically add Notion pages. And as you can see here, I'm gonna have, if you go to select pages, I'm gonna have business finances selected and allow access. And this is pretty standard across any app that kind of integrates with Notion or anything like that. And then what you're gonna do is basically see that these are the databases that exist on the page. And anytime you make a new one, just refresh it and it'll pull it in there. So now in order to make a new chart, as you can see, you have two free charts left. I have three made. That means that there's five in the free plan. And if you quickly look at the upgrade section here with the Stripe checkout, subscribe to Notion Charts Pro, limited time price, it's $199 per month, unlimited charts, all chart types, future updates, and premium features. So basically, I'm gonna press create chart, go to the monthly overhead breakdown first, and then I want it broken out by the specifics. So that would mean that it's the payment name, because that, if we go back here, this is like the specific thing rather than the category. So if we go payment name, and then the amount, so for the y-axis, you're gonna wanna pick the dollar amount. That's just like you want a numeric value for the y-axis. And then we can sort it by amount, group it by sum, and then go to pie chart. And then this is kind of how we have the breakdown how it was before. So then if we go to, we can do single color or multicolor, and we could turn on dark mode, as well as this is kind of where data will sync up. So if I change the numbers here, so if I go to change it from 12 to 12, 120, you'll see very quickly that this chart changes into something that's obviously a little different than what it was prior. So if I go and change that and then refresh it again, I have it in dark mode, which is perfect. And then at the top, I can change it to monthly overhead breakdown specifics. And if you want to see some other visualizations, you can see there's a bar graph there vertically. You can see there's a horizontal bar graph. You can see that there's a line graph, obviously a area graph as well. So these are just the different type of visualizations that you can get. So if we get a comp embed URL here, and we go back to Notion, we go here, I can do slash embed and then paste in that link, and it will load in here. And in order to just resize it, we want to click on the bottom right, and it'll take a second, and we just want to get whatever we want regarding the entirety of the percentages to show. So we can see here, we actually could do something like this. So if we want to get rid of the data labels, if I did that, and then if I press refresh in the top left here, that would get rid of that as well. Now, if we wanna go back and put them on or get rid of the title, same situation, press refresh, it'll do the same thing. Now, we obviously can do the exact same thing for the other side of things. So if we go to monthly expected income, let's say we made another graph. So if we went to monthly expected income, monthly expected income specifics, and then we go once again to the payment name, amount, sort by, you do the amount, and then we can do a pie graph once again, turn it on to dark mode, copy the embed URL, go back, paste this create embed. Don't even need to do slash embed. That's why I wanted to show you two examples. We can line it up with the other one. And as you can see, we have two graphs quickly created in Notion based off of databases. Something that's interesting. So if I actually turned these into negatives, this pie chart wouldn't work. So if I turned it to negative 12, you can see immediately that the Google My Business or Google Business Plan will not properly work. So unfortunately, this does need to be all positive for pie charts. I think it's because, you know, you can't make a negative of a whole. However, for the way that this works, I mean, it's like, yeah, I get it, but wanted to point that out. So you do want to make sure when you're making a pie chart like this that it is a positive number. Obviously, if you don't, it won't work and then you'll be confused. However, for things like bar graphs, you can do negative numbers and they're totally fine.
If you like this video and want to check out any of my other stuff at Rise Productive, please make sure to go to riseproductive.com and check out my Notion templates. I also offer free coaching calls for things like Notion, as well as just overall life organization. So if you want to have a chat with me there, please go to riseproductive.com and check out everything we have to offer for you there. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.